calls to save a stand of old-growth forest on 50 hectares just north of Port Renfrew on southern Vancouver Island. The Ancient Forest Alliance says the provincial government has no old-growth strategy, and some of the biggest trees in the world could fall. Bruce Kirkpatrick reports.
Steam from the morning sun after record rain near Port Renfrew. They've logged here in the past, and the Ancient Forest Alliance worries they'll log again. It is a pristine area with lakes and rivers and otters. It could be an international tourist destination on a circle route from Victoria, covering Port Renfrew, Lake Cowichan, back to Victoria. Walking into Avatar Grove, discovered by Ken Wu and TJ Watt of the Ancient Forest Alliance last December. It's part of TFL 46, held by J.S. Jones Company, which has been working in the area. It is crown land under forest license, and Ken Wu says giant trees like this spruce, possibly the biggest in the world, must be saved.
This should be a no-brainer. As opposed to what? Logging this area to provide half a dozen jobs for 1 or 2 months? That's totally a nearsighted perspective, and you know, we need some higher level thinking here, and as well as, you know, realizing that the long-term future of Port Renfrew is going to rely on ecotourism.
Deeper into the woods and a giant burl in the distance, again maybe the biggest anywhere. In the Grove, a Capital Regional District Director for Juan de Fuca and the area MLA.
The natural history of British Columbia and is right beside Port Renfrew. And it'll be the biggest draw, much like Clackwood Sound was for Tofino. This is the draw for Port Renfrew.
The circle route, bringing people from around the world to southern Vancouver Island, benefits from these trees standing up, not from them lying down on the ground.
There are already spray paint markings on some trees here and ribbons denoting forest industry intention. Industry passes close by. Wu and Hicks would rather the trees remain upright. But what about jobs, work in the forest? Employment.
There's lots of second growth to cut, and I don't think any logger would look at this and say, they'd say the same thing. Leave the thing alone. Let their kids see it. Let the future see it.
The Ancient Forest Alliance says there's just 4% of old growth forest left on flat land close to civilization on southern Vancouver Island. An ancient battle, industry and the environment, and some very big trees.
Forest Minister Pat Bell is in Whistler at the Union of BC Municipalities Convention and unavailable to talk to us today. But in the past, the Forest Ministry has said the trees are in Grant's Grove, which is on First Nation land, and the province has not had an application for a cutting permit yet.